What's that? It's got low power silhouette. What's that? Yeah, that's a Poroma, right? We've got a nodule. This one's even got like the little gutter, or what's the word that you guys use? Yeah, it's got a collarette, and it's got like a little channel, a furrow around the outside, a little groove that's dipped down in, and the lesion is bulging up. It's often ulcerated or inflamed or crusted on the top. Okay, and you have this really marked acanthosis, proliferation of the epidermis of these small little round keratinocytes that are pushing way down, and sometimes it'll be thick like this. Sometimes they're actual finger-like extensions that are pushing down from the epidermis into the dermis. And when you look closer, these cells are, yes, they'll be ducts. These cells are very round nuclei. They have a little bit of cytoplasm, and they can have some clear cell change. The bits of stroma in between, the bits of papillary dermis that are entrapped, tend to be very edematous. See how white and clear that is? Very edematous, and also very sclerotic. They'll have dilated vessels. They'll have sclerotic collagen or basement membrane material, real dense pink stuff, and they'll have edema. That dense pink stuff goes along well with many different sweat gland tumors and even other adnexal tumors. Here's some right here. This is like basement membrane material laid down in here, big dilated vessels, edema, inflammation. Those are common findings. And then finding the ducts can sometimes be hard, but like in this case, it's worth looking around. So you look for tiny little holes. The big spaces end up usually being vessels, actually. So don't say, oh, look at the duct. That's actually a vessel because it's surrounded by dermis, see? It's a little space, and then it's got dermis or collagen around it. Say there, too. It's a vessel. It's got serum, blood cells, and then it's got its own little bit of collagen around it. A duct is not going to have collagen around it because it's being formed by the epithelial cells. That's probably a duct, a little tiny hole. And sometimes you can see a little pink layer we call cuticle that lines the inside of that. If you really want to prove it, you can do like a CEA or an EMA to highlight those little duct spaces. Some people have shown that c-kit expression is seen in poromas and porocarcinomas. A lot of times I just diagnose it on H&E. And again, the differential would be like, is this a funny seb? Inflamed sebs or inverted follicular keratosis, those can look quite a bit like poroma, and the difference is they're all benign things, right? Because poromas are cooler, and so we like to diagnose those when we can. Poroma. And I believe poromas are etiologically on a spectrum with hidradenomas. I think they're like in the same family, because you can see areas that look very much like hidradenoma in poroma. You can see hidradenomas that connect up to the surface and on the top look like a poroma and on the bottom look like a hidradenoma. So I believe they kind of all belong to the acrospiroma family. And again, dermpaths love to split and resplit and then argue and fight with each other about who's splitting is right. But it doesn't matter if it's a benign sweat gland tumor, it's okay. Just breathe and let it go. It'll be fine. Okay. Poroma.